Greetings, I am the Cartoon Hero. Well, it's time for a brand new season of my show, and have I got a treat for you. Today we're going to be looking at a pilot I've had on the back burner for some time now on this edition of...
Cartoons That Never Made It.
And today I'm more excited than usual because we'll finally be getting to take another look at Hellboy. Sort of. It's no secret at this point that I'm a Hellboy fan. I've read most of the comics, but of course I wouldn't have gotten into them were it not for the Guillermo del Toro live-action films, which I still say are great fun. A few years ago, I also reviewed both direct-to-video animated Hellboy films, Sword of Storms and Blood and Iron, which featured the Hellboy live-action cast reprising their roles and were helmed by animation veteran Tad Stones, creator of Darkwing Duck. Those movies were also quite entertaining, one that had great action and one that had surprisingly good horror. Needless to say, I recommend all four movies, and I really hope that Ron Perlman is successful in campaigning for a fifth. I think what helped the movies be so good is that Mike Mignola, Hellboy's creator, was involved and really wanted to help them succeed. But that isn't the only project Mignola has contributed to. Not only was he an animator on my favorite animated film of all time, Disney's Atlantis: The Lost Empire, which I loved even before I became a Hellboy fan, but at one point Mignola penned a different comic which later became an animated pilot. The idea started out as Mike Mignola noticing that often superhero action figures just looked like the same figure with different paint jobs and heads. This gave him the idea of a robot head who could screw himself into different robot bodies that suited the situation. And thus, the amazing screw-on head and other curious objects was born. What started out as a one-shot comic was eventually reworked into a pilot shown on the Sci-Fi channel. Why it didn't get picked up is a mystery to me, but from what I can tell, the pilot was put online with a survey at the time, so maybe it just didn't test as well as Sci-Fi hoped it would. But knowing my fans so far, they'll probably find an interview with the creator that explains everything buried in some obscure corner of the web. Well, regardless, let's see what's buried in the history that could have been with the amazing screw-on head.